Hi friends, in this video we are going to see about Benjamin's proteins. Benjamin's proteins in urine, that Benjamin's proteins nothing but it's a para protein, like it has light chains of kappa or lambda chains, which is excreted and elevated in urine, elevated in blood or excreted in urine. So 50% of the multiple myeloma patients have excreted Benjamin's proteins in urine, and it will be a kappa or lambda chains of the light chain. So we are all know the light chain and heavy chains of antibodies, that kappa or lambda present in light chains, that is elevated in a urine. It is molecular weight 45,000, and has sedimentation coefficients 3.5s. sometimes chains excreted may be dimer or of L chains, light chains or dimerly it will be produced. The identifications, we are identified by the heat test using a urine sample. Protein is identified easily in urine by the simple heat test. On heating 50 to 60 degrees Celsius, we can heat the sample, urine sample that will be heated. We can identify the Benjamin's proteins. So Benjamin's proteins are precipitated when we are heating the samples. The Benjamin's proteins are precipitated, but when heated further, it dissolved again. Okay, reverse against cooling. The process will be reversed when we are cooling. Best detected by zone electrophoresis and immunoelectrophoresis also. The concentration of concentrated urine will be used for this electrophoresis techniques. Normally very amount minute quantities of kappa and lambda immunoglobulins are present in urine. Benjamin's proteins are precipitated when urine sample is heated, but when we heated further, it will be dissolved again. It will be reversed on cooling process. The best detected ways, that is zone electrophoresis. We can use zone electrophoresis or immunoelectrophoresis for detecting the Benjamin's proteins using the concentrated urine samples, but the small amount of kappa and lambda immunoglobulin chains, light chains, are only present in the sample, resulted in the zone electrophoresis and immunoelectrophoresis. The pass through the glomerular filtrate, but are reabsorbed by the kidney tubules. Kidney tubules are reabsorbed the Benjamin's proteins or light chains of kappa and lambda chains, which will be reabsorbed into a circulations, and small amount will be excreted in the urine. It will be broken down or lining the cells, found in a urine. So it's a three-dimensional of the Benjamin's proteins produced by the X-ray crystallography picture. Okay, it is explanations of PJ proteins. When the WBC cells are produce B lymphocytes, that time antigen if present, plasma cells will produce immunoglobulins, that is antibody. If the antibody has the light chain, the part of kappa and lambda, both are present in light chains only, that will be separate, and any one will be excreted in the urine. That is called the BJ proteins. So it is a healthy bone marrow and multiple myeloma conditions. Healthy bone marrow, white blood cells produce, when the antigen are present, plasma cells, it will be converted in plasma cells and produce antibodies that will be cleave the antigens. When multiple myeloma is came to the bone marrow and damages, it will be damage the DNA and damage the white bloods also. It's a warrior cells of a human, and it will be produce the multiple myeloma cells, and it will be produce the myeloma proteins, which can cause the cancer, even blood cancer also. Benjamin's proteins is a monoclonal globulin proteins or immunoglobulin light chains found in urine. Molecular weight 22 to 24 kilodalton. Reductions of Benz proteins may be suggested that multiple myeloma or Van Rooms macroglobulinemia conditions. So Benjamin's proteins particularly diagnosed for the multiple myeloma, and other than the multiple myeloma, kidney failures, lytic bone lesions, which is bone lesions or comes out from the vessels. That is what called the lytic bone lesions. Anemia conditions, large amount of plasma cells in the bone marrow. These are all other conditions which Benjamin's proteins are elevated in the blood and urine. So 2/3 of multiple myeloma cases has the level of elevated level of Benjamin's proteins in urine and blood. Proteins are immunoglobulin light chains that is called a paraprotein that produced by the neoplastic plasma cells, and they can be kappa or lambda. Either any one will be present in the urine samples. Mostly kappa chains will be present in the urine sample. Light chains can be immunoglobulin fragment, single homogeneous immunoglobulins. They are found in the urine result of decreased kidney filtration capabilities due to kidney failure. If the kidney doesn't filtrate properly or work properly, it can't be reabsorbed by the kidney, so it will be elevated can be elevated in the urine. So patient producing low level of immunoglobulin free light chains seems non-secretory multiple myeloma and AL amyloidosis. So Benjamin's proteins urine test is one of the several tests used to diagnose a type of blood cancer known as a multiple myeloma, and between 50% and 80% of people who have a multiple myeloma, they have elevated levels of Benjamin's proteins in a urine and serums. It also linked to cancers of lymphatic systems, lymphoma, which we're calling the lymphatic system tumor, and Benjamin's proteins is a building block of antibodies made by the cancerous tumors. Healthy urine. Healthy human doesn't have the Benjamin's proteins in their urine sample. If it gets elevated in urine, that persons have some healthy problem. It is an indications of the health problem. And other names of test include urine protein electrophoresis UPEP and urine immunofixation electrophoresis or immunoassay for free light chains. So main uses of Benjamin's proteins urine test is to diagnosis and monitoring the multiple myeloma. The patients who have the multiple myeloma, they have treatment, they had in treatment, so we can monitoring the patients with the treatment levels and diagnosis the cancer levels. So multiple myeloma happens when the plasma cells which makes antibodies fight infections start to multiply uncontrolled and release Benjamin's proteins. This protein does not serve any useful functions in the body. Multiple myeloma can cause following blood problems, which means anemia, thrombocytopenia and leukopenia. Anemia is a shortages of red blood cells that can lead to a weakness and exhaustion, and thrombocytopenia, shortages of thrombocytes or blood platelets. That condition is called thrombocytopenia. It platelet will be helped in blood clotting. If platelet will be low, that time the bleeding problems and brushing problems will be occurred. Leukopenia are shortages of white blood cells, which is a warrior cells, which can weaken the immune system. WBC cells is fighting with the infectious disease or foreign substance. If the WBC substance or level will be low, that time immune system will be weakened. That condition is called leukopenia. So have also linked the Benjamin's proteins to cancers of lymphatic system, including lymphoma and Waldenstrom microglobulinemia. Lymphoma is a cancer in lymphatic systems. Symptoms may include bone pain, fracture, particularly in the back pain, hip or skull. There is a fractures may be occur, confusion or dizziness, and weakness and swellings of legs. Multiple infections. Once the WBC cells levels are lower, that time mostly all of the infections will occur on the patient. Other indicators of multiple myeloma including high level of calcium in the blood, low level of red or white blood cells. This is what we are seeing in previous slides. So red blood cells lower the level is called anemia, and white blood cells is a leukopenia. Low level of platelet it is called thrombocytopenia. So high level of calcium is called hypercalcemia. That calcium can be blocked the Benjamin's proteins, so it will be elevated in a urine. may uses an X-ray or MRI to look for bone damages and take a bone marrow samples. It is a diagnostic test. So it's a diagnostic test. The patient's 24-hour samples will be collected from the patients who are having the multiple myeloma conditions. That the patients will be pass the first urine when he so it's a diagnosis points. The patients who are having the multiple myeloma, the patients should collect the 24 hours urine sample, which is a 1 day urine sample. We have to collect the patients should collect it, and the time will be calculated on that label. Whenever the patients are passing the urine, that will be collected in the container and the timing will be noted. And first urine samples which is not collected and it will be if we are going to run about the tumor patients, we should collect the patient's history for a further process. So result means ordinary patients doesn't have, ordinary healthy men doesn't have the Benjamin's proteins in urine. If present, there is a health problem in that patients that should make the further treatment of patients. So Benjamin's proteins may also present in conditions called monoclonal gammopathy, undetermined significance, MGUS. MGUS is a plasma cells that produce one or more proteins in the blood cells that do not form a tumor or otherwise damage their body. Okay, it is this condition progressive that can lead to a disease called blood cancer. They may lead to the blood cancer and indicate the multiple myeloma. High level of Benjamin's proteins indicate the multiple myeloma and together with the tumor also, such as lymphoma, Waldstrom, microglobulinemia. Doctor may diagnose smoldering myeloma if Benjamin's proteins are blood show normal blood counts, normal calcium levels and kidney functions. Smoldering myeloma is early stage myeloma. It does not cause symptoms, but it will be monitored. So this is the last slide for BJ proteins. If you guys like my video, please subscribe my channel and hit the like button and comment. Thank you.